What's up? It's Saturday! So today, I'm going to do my theme of the week. I didn't think people would listen to me. Until then, I hadn't really realized that there's these people on the internet that are watching me and responding to me, and I'm like having a live conversation with them, and it makes me kind of happy. And I just want to say thank you for doing this. I've learned Kate's name, and Sophia's name, and Maggie's name. Yes, and Anna's name. Oh, win! I have them all. I win. All right. So now to my bookshelf. This is my bookshelf. I have lots of books here, and I'm going to take you through every single shelf, but not every single book, because that would take forever, and I have 20 minutes, because I have to go to swim really soon. So here we go. The top shelf is kind of my schoolish books. I have A Midsummer Night's Dream, which I read in 6th grade, and Frank, which I read in the summer before 7th grade. I read Jane Eyre in 7th grade, because I had to read a classic, and I don't have the book, because I borrowed it from my teacher, but I have the Spark Notes, because that was really confusing, especially when you're just in middle school. And I have A Tale of Two Cities, which is really good. I'm very proud. I got through it in 3 days. I read nonstop because I had a week before school and I was supposed to read it for school. So I just kind of went read all day, every day for 3 days. And then I finished. And it was actually pretty good. And I would totally reread that again if I had more time. To Kill a Mockingbird. I think that's the last one for school I had to read. Oh no. The last one I had to read was Frederick Douglass, An American Slave. The narrative of the life of Frederick Douglass, An American Slave. Here is where my school books end and begin. Classic section that I haven't read. So these are all the ones I have read and the ones I haven't read. And in between is a Spanish to Portuguese dictionary. This is my second journal. I got it at IKEA. My first one is pink and it's just like this. And it's locked in a box that I cannot open because I've lost the key. I'm also not sure where it is. So yeah. And then, anyway, so this is my second journal that I made and it's like completely filled, but it's really illegible. And then here are my two journals. This one I finished filling out. It was like my fourth journal or something. It's got stuff in there. That was a spare for when I finished the one I have now. The Stranger of Albert Camus. There we go. It's in French. I haven't read this one because I haven't had time, but it's required reading for IB. You know the thing I'm doing for school, the diploma program. I told you guys about it. And I'm going to have to read that probably junior year. These are some of my favorite books. Night World, it's like a really good series by L.J. Smith. The Host is Stephanie Meyer's best book ever, even though she's only written five. No, she's written six. These Things Hidden. This was a present from my friend Judy. I have Willow. I thought that one was beautiful. If I Stay was wonderful. The Hunger Games series. I have all the Hunger Games series, but I have the rest on sale. Shiver was so beautiful. From the last day of school in, I think it was 6th grade. This one was good. I love the title. One of those hideous books where the mother dies. And to the Lemony Snicket collector, I say, unauthorized biography, Lemony Snicket. I'm that cool. On to my series bookshelf. That was series, not serious. It's not serious. I told you guys last time, I finished this one Tuesday. I have the Aragorn series, the Inheritance Cycle, City of Bones, I guess is a series, I don't know the series name. City of Bones, I have the first two for Perfect Chemistry by Elkalis. I have these by Sarah Dessen. I have this one, but my friend's borrowing it, which is why I only have the cover. I have the first three of the Twilight Saga, just by height, not by preference. And this one is Buti, Estos Amigos de Amazonia. This one's in Portuguese, and it's like an eco-friendly book. That's really cool. It's like pop-out. Gran Enciclopedia de los Seres Mágicos, which is in Spanish. It's an encyclopedia of magical creatures. It's really cool. I should show you guys a little bit. Oh, by the way, that National Geographic magazine. I loved seeing that. See? Look. Isn't that pretty? It's got like different sections. It's all in Spanish. It's got like magical creatures and stuff and mermaids. It's kind of cool actually. A minotaur, fairies,
magic recipes, some more stuff in Spanish, some little kid books, The Diary of a Wimpy Kid, Matilda, A Wrinkle in Time, Papelucho. This is the only lemony snicket book I have. The end. Oh, these are the books I've read in Spanish. These are a bunch of biographies about famous Mexican people. Down here I have more school stuff, but these are like workbooks for French, AP Human Geography, math, history. I have some biographies I haven't read in Spanish. Harry Potter in Spanish, and these are translations to Spanish. And some more stuff here. Wow, that took a long time. So yeah, that was a tour of my bookshelf. I love telling people about my bookshelf, the type of it. I have to go get ready for swim. I will finish this video. I guess you guys will see the next part right now. I'm back! And it's a day later because I was filming that on Friday because I wasn't sure I was going to have enough time today, but I do, so I'm going to finish my video. I told you guys I was going to do something for you, and I have, shall we say, presents for you. My little sister's helping right now, so we're going to wait for her to finish. But basically, I have these books. That I don't want anymore because I was cleaning them out to arrange this beautiful thing behind me here that I did just recently. It's kind of the reason I wanted to introduce it. And so I'm going to give them to whoever wants them. Welcome! Now come look at my books. Ready. So my offer to you guys is I will let you have any of these books that I'm going to give away since I'm going to give away now. Here we go. And I will give you some of them, okay? So I will give these books to you just in your replies to your videos, or you just post it on a comment below. Just say which one you want, and then you can email me. My email is below. You can tell me which one you want and the address so I can pack it up and send it. I really hope you take me up on this offer because I really want these books to find very good home. For now, I have nothing more to say. Punishment. There must be people there, and they must hear you, and you must film every second of it. You will go to a children's section, grab a pretty lengthy children's picture book, and you must read it aloud, very loudly. It's loud, so loud that people actually stop and look at you. And if you hold story time, then you will get extra hug points. Yeah. So with our punishment, we will be helping the community. Won't that be amazing? I will see you all for the rest of the week. You will see me next Saturday. Look at my owl.